boogie. And then shall a nurse him in 100 shekels, okay, two, I'm way out. Virgin or not, this is where I am, okay, here I am. I apologize, it's Deuteronomy 22, starting at about 14. And give occasion of speech against her, saying, bring up the woman shall be garment, coming with her, and the man shall take over. If any man take a wife, and go in unto her, and hate her, okay, this is just the beginning. If any man take a wife and go into her, then that's at 22:13. And if any man take a wife and should go unto her and hate her, this is the beginning of talking about a wife and taking a wife. The very first part of 14 on down, just talking about one's idealism. And give occasion of speech against her and bring up evil name upon her and say, I took this woman, and when I came to her, I found her not a maid. Here we go. This is it. 14. There it is. 22 and 14. It starts at 13, rather. If a man take a wife and go in unto her and hate her, and give occasion of speech against her, and bring up an evil name upon her, and say, I took this woman, and when I came to her, I found her not a maid. Then shall the father of the damsel and the mother take and bring forth the tokens of the damsel's virginity unto the elders of the city in the gates, and the damsel's father shall say unto her, elders, I gave my daughters unto this man to wife, and he hated her, and a maid have given occasion of speech against her, saying, I found her not thy daughter of maid, and yet these are the tokens of my daughter's virginity. And they shall spread the cloth before the elders of the city, and the elders of the city shall take the man and chastise him. And they shall immerse him in 100 shekels of silver, and give them unto the fathers of the damsel, because he have brought up an evil name upon a virgin of Israel, and she shall be his wife. He may not put her away all the days of his life. But listen, it says, but if this thing be true, at 20, chapter Deuteronomy 22, it starts at 13, but it really gets to our point at the verse 20. But I say read it all. I would say read the whole thing. It will make a sense to read the whole thing here. And it says at 20, but if this thing be true, and this is the law which they were keeping, which allegedly Joseph was keeping, allegedly Mary was keeping, because there was no JC yet to deliver them from their sins, so the New Testament say. So the New Testament says. There was no JC yet, no Jesus yet. And this is the law that they were keeping. Now, it says here, let's go back. When his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. She was locked up before they had sex. Now here it is. If a man take a wife and go in unto her and hate her, and give occasion of speech against her, and bring up an evil name upon her, and say, I took this woman, and when I came to her, I found her not a maid. And it says, but if this thing be true, and now skip from there to verse 22 and 20, I trust you will read the whole chapter myself, and I beg you to read the whole chapter, but jump from verse 22 to 20, but if this thing be true, and the tokens of her virginity be not found for the damsel, then they shall bring out the damsel to the door of the father's house, and the men of her city shall stone her with stones that they die, because she has wrought a folly in Israel to play the whore in her father's house. So shall thou put evil away from among you. Word is burning. There it is. Verse 22. If a man be found lying with a woman, married to her husband, and they shall find both of them, and they shall both of them die. both the man that lie with the woman and the woman, so shall they put away evil from among Israel. If a damsel that is a virgin be betrothed unto a husband, we're 23 now, and a man find her in the city and lie with her, then they shall bring them both out of the gates of the city, that ye shall stone them with stones that they die. The damsel, because thy cried not, being in the city, and the man, because he hath humbled his neighbor's wife, so thou shalt put away evil from among you. Word is bound. That's hard. That's super hard right there. Why you PMing me? It's only me and you in here, bro. I mean, you know, say what you gotta say. It's all gravy. It's all gravy. I'm just making a recording of some conscious, hard shit. Killing JC. What? So where we at? Okay, right here. If a damsel be a virgin and be betrothed unto her husband, a man find her and lay with her in the city, if they were dead, then he shall bring both of them in the gates of the city, and ye shall stone them with stones that they die. The damsel, because she cried not, being in the city, and the man, because he had humbled his neighbor's wife, so thou shalt put away evil from among you. That's gangster. Now, sure, whatever. Do whatever you gotta do. It is what it is. Get another one. Fuck it. Fuck it. Now, I'm showing you that from Matthew 1 to 16, this is Joseph, the stepfather of Jesus, birthright. Then I'm showing you, when you get down to the carrying away the buffalo, it was fictitious. And when I get down to 18, I'm showing you that Mary and this man named Joseph were married. And then when I get down to Matthew 1 and 19, it shows you that Joseph, her husband, then you know that your man, being a just man, was not willing to make a public example and was minded to put her away privily. I'm showing you that neither one of them kept the law. I'm showing you that the law said such, and he didn't follow it. And there was no JC there to use as an excuse. You know, that's some fictitious reason. I don't know the Lord and God there. You know, Lord King James said something and came appeared unto a dreamer. I don't know. They say some lame shit. It is what it is. And Joseph, her husband, being a just man, wanted to put her away privately. He knew that's what he should have did. Then when 20 says some angel came in a dream and blah, 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 blah. Now check big what it says. To let you know this book is a lie. And right after I get to this, I'm going to go to show you about the bastard child. And that will make JC a bastard child. Him having a father or a sperm donor or a seed donor who was not his mother's husband. That makes him a bastard child. That makes him born, he's in outside of wedlock. Those two were not wedded, so that would be outside of wedlock. Not because she married to someone else would count. Those particular two must be married, and they wasn't. Whoever impregnated her, whoever volunteered to see, it is what it is. You get down here to 19, we'll be down here 20, but while he thought about these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Jehoshaphat, thou son of David, fear not to take thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost, and she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name, right here 21, Jesus.